Hi. One of the things I have wanted to create for a long time is a 3D simulator for the Danish RoboCup competition. While we do get access to the physical track about a week before the competition, it is always quite crowded when all teams are testing the robots at the same time. So I thought it would be easier to test my robot in a simulator. This year I finally found the time to build a realistic 3D model of both the track and my robot. I use the Webots robotic simulator for this. It's a free and open source tool that can simulate a 3D world so that a virtual camera on the robot can see what the physical robot would see. It can also simulate physics, so the robot will stop if it hits a fixed object, or for example simulate the seesaw realistically when the robot passes the tipping point. To make the track as accurate as possible, I took a photo from above and corrected the perspective to get a fairly precise map of the lines on the floor. Of course, stuff above the floor gets skewed in that image, so I modeled the obstacles, like the stairs and the ramp and the seesaw, in 3D. By placing these models on the map, I was able to create a fairly accurate version of the track. The next challenge was getting the robot's old software to run in the simulator. To do that, I had to completely refactor my code so that all sensors are separated into a standalone module. Now I can connect the controller software either to the real sensors on the robot or to the equivalent simulated ones in Webots. This means that I can run the exact same code in the simulator as I do on the real robot. But how accurate is the simulator? My robot is controlled by a camera, and here are some examples showing how the virtual camera sees the world compared to how it looks in reality. It took quite some time to learn how to use Webots and to build the 3D models, so I didn't have time to recreate every part of the track. But the parts that I did simulate worked really well. As a result, I was able to program most of the robot's behavior in the simulator, and I only had to adjust a few constants by 50 to 100 millimeters to match the physical dimensions of the real track. Next year, the competition track will change, so I will need to update the simulator accordingly. But the foundation I built should make it easy to adapt for next time. Hopefully, that means that I can focus more on programming additional parts of the track for next year's competition.